Thanks, Niranjan. It's been a pleasure to be here. And I, wonderful. Well, I started working in 1989. That's ancient, in some sense. And in NCA, which is a think tank. So then I think from a think tank, when there I did a variety of things, maybe we can discuss. From there I moved to CERC, which is Central Electricity Regulatory Commission. So that is the regulation had just started. So I wanted to put my foot there and be a first generation regulator. But I think that regulation is still a long way to go, and I got disappointed pretty quickly. But anyway, that was a good learning for me. And then from there, I moved on to PRISIL. The Center for Economic Research was set up in 2002. And I think I've been there in PRISIL ever since. So what do we do? I mean, my daughter, who's 9 and a half, often asks me, Papa, what is it that you do in your office? I think I see sometimes, I see a picture somewhere, but what is it that you do? I find it very difficult to explain to her what I do. But maybe I think it would be easier. I think very broadly, see, economy is like a big jigsaw puzzle. And you have to make sense of it. And there's so many things happening. How do you interpret what's going on and try to extend it, look forward, which is forecasting. So I think that in a very simple term would be my job. So what does it involve? I think it can involve, if you get into a very technical area, you could be a macro modeling specialist, and I think you'll get a kick out of building large macro models, very interactive, I think, and forecasting out of that. That is what we do, but I think in PRISIL, we don't have a macroeconomic model, but we have hired one. The Oxford Economics has a very big global model which the S&P has hired, and, which means you pay a fee and you get to use it. And there's an India module also which we run out of here, which is plugged into all the other economies. So if anything happens anywhere in the world, but it gets reflected in. Then I think we also look at, these days everybody is asking, oh, if Brexit happens, if China slows down, what's going to happen to India? So looking at interlinkages, I think that is that, and I think that is also one of the things that we do. Then finally, I think talking to the stakeholders, I think that's, being in a corporate setting, it's very critical that you interact with various clients of yours, give them, try to explain what's going on, and then they come back a year after, 6 months after, saying that, well, you said this, but this happened. So I think it's a very challenging, I mean, working in a think tank is easier, I mean, in some sense. I mean, you're paid to do some work, you do that, and you have a different kind of flexibility. But here you have to be on your toes, and that's one difference. Now, I work in a credit rating agency. It started off as a credit rating agency, but people, these days it's not a credit rating agency anymore. Only 25% of our revenue comes from credit rating. Rest is all research, global as well as domestic. So what is the biggest kick I got was working in PRISIL, because what happens there is, it gives you a multidisciplinary environment. There are about 80 sectors being tracked by research guys on a regular basis. And then there are credit ratings going on. So we have outstanding ratings on about 15,000 firms. So you have ground level data on that. And then I think a couple of thousand small and medium enterprises as well as are rated. So I think what it does, I think, is that it allows an economist to synthesize and embed those findings into your macro story. I think that is where it gives you a different, I mean, it's, applying macroeconomic principles is one thing, but also synthesizing. I mean, many of the economists like Alfred Marshall, etc., were historians also. They were mathematicians, but they were also, in some sense, they also knew history, they also knew philosophy. So I think being able to synthesize, I think that is one quality. If you develop that, I think you can definitely become a successful economist. And then I think what I've seen, when I started working, the opportunities were very limited. Corporates did not hire economists. But these days everywhere, whether it is the public sector or it is the private sector, whether it is banks, multilaterals, you name it, I think the industry bodies, everywhere I think there is requirement for the economists, because the economy itself is becoming more and more complex, and the data flow is very, very fast, and you need to make sense out of it as quickly as possible. And then let me close it. I don't want to speak much, but I mean, when we look at hiring somebody, so what do we look at? How do we? So first thing, at least I would look at is the attitude. I mean, that sounds very strange, but I think somebody who's willing to learn, willing to go through hard work, and also I think is curious. I think that's the first thing I try to identify in whomsoever I have. Then comes, I think, the other issues like the conceptual clarity of, I mean, which I think academies like Vecna Desai Institute give you, I mean, they teach you about the nuts and bolts of the knowledge. Then analytical capability, etc. These things are very important. I think this is very critical for drawing conclusions out of a lot of data that you encounter. Then comes the third part, I think, which is communication. And whatever you've done, I think the person should be able to tell it to the other person in a very simple way, in a very communicable way. The other person should get it what you are trying to say. I think what I have noted in my 25 years or 26 years of work is that the work that is not communicated well, it just ends there. I mean, it might be a very fine piece of work, but I think communication is very, very critical for an economist particularly. And then I think obviously the other skills, like you need to be proficient in some software these days, I think econometrics, etc. So I think that's what I would broadly say is, I mean, the qualities that we look for, I mean, when we hire. I think attitude is, I would still put it at number one. I mean, people should be willing to work hard in the initial years, and I think put in a lot of labor. And then I think these days, what I'm not trying to cast aspersions on anybody, but it's the food oriented. I mean, quickly, I mean, how quickly I get a result out of it. I think that you need to be willing to work hard and learn, and I think and synthesize, embed it, and so on and so forth. So I think with that, let me. I hope I haven't spoken much. But.